This is the OCN minus Lewis structure, the cyanate ion. For the cyanate ion, we have a total of 16 valence electrons. That includes this negative up here. Carbon is the least electronegative. We'll put that at the center, and then an oxygen here, and a nitrogen over here. We'll put two electrons between atoms to form a chemical bond. Then we'll go around the outside. So we have 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16. We've used all our valence electrons at this point. Oxygen and nitrogen have 8 valence electrons, so they're good, but the carbon only has 4. So we're going to need to share valence electrons from the outer atoms with the carbon so that it can have an octet. The question is, do we share from the oxygen or from the nitrogen, or both? Nitrogen is less electronegative than oxygen. That means it's more likely to give up valence electrons to share them. So let's move them from the nitrogen. So let's take 2 from here and form a double bond. And now the carbon has 6, so we need to move 2 more. Let's put those in there. So now nitrogen, it has 8, but the carbon also has 8. And we're still only using 16 valence electrons. When we calculate the formal charges, we'll find that the oxygen has a formal charge of -1, carbon is 0, and nitrogen is 0. That makes a lot of sense. We have a -1 up here, and the negative charge in our OCN minus Lewis structure is on the most electronegative atom. So this looks like a pretty good Lewis structure. We could form double bonds between the oxygen and then between the carbon and nitrogen, and you'd see that that would work from an octet standpoint, but when we check our formal charges, we'd have a -1 on the nitrogen. And that doesn't make sense because nitrogen is less electronegative. So this right here is the best Lewis structure for OCN minus. I'm Dr. B, and thanks for watching.